I think growing up in a small town was great for me because ever since I was probably in junior high school, I always had this feeling like there is so much more to life and I really want to just see the world. And I always just had this dream of being famous someday, but I just never knew how I wanted to be famous, you know? When I was about 14, you know, of course, modeling, I think all girls at age 14 want to get into modeling because it seems so exciting and everything. And that's about the time that I went down to the big city of Boise and tried my hand at modeling with the only agency in Idaho.
We lived in McCall and it was 100 miles away up a mountain, and I drove her down here, you know, 100 miles away to all that stuff because she had a boyfriend that we didn't like, and so we were trying to get her switched over to thinking about something else, so I thought that might be good, but in retrospect it probably wasn't.
When a lady sat behind her desk with her big fake lashes on, you know, "Could you lose a few pounds?" That's what she told me. "Could you please lose a few pounds?" She asked me to lose a few pounds, 5 pounds, and I lost 10. Came back, "Oh, you look great." So I thought, the more I lose, the more I can please her. And that's when my roller coaster with my eating disorder started.
Her eating disorder lasted probably from about 15 to about 19, I'd say. That's when she was in the modeling, and you know, when you're a teenager, you have kind of a plump little face, and so the desire was is to get her face thin. Well, that wasn't her. I mean, she couldn't do that, and so she would think that she could not eat, and that would be the way to go. I had sort of had an idea, and I was getting an inclination, but this one Thanksgiving I remember in particular, she kept saying how hungry she was and when was dinner going to be ready and all that. And so we sat down and ate, and I can still remember how shocked I was, even though I sort of had a suspicion, when she was so hungry and she took like a teaspoon, I mean literally a teaspoon of each thing and put it on her plate. So here's this big plate and these little dabs of food, and it just sent goosebumps down my spine because I knew.
When she would have a Diet Coke for lunch or just a cucumber, you know, just not eating with us anymore, that's kind of when I noticed that.
My friends and family were always asking me what I ate during the day and commenting on my body and how sickly I looked. But when they told me I looked sick, I thought that meant I looked good, and I was excited inside that they told me that. You don't want them to tell you you look healthy because that means you're fat. I was extremely compulsive about exercise. You know, actually, I started working out probably about the age of 11, but I would, you know, go home from 7th grade, probably go home and start riding the Stairmaster an hour a day. And then by the time I was 14 years old, I was riding it 2 hours a day. After school, I'd ride my bike. I was a fixture at the gym.
Oh, I think she was obsessed. I think she was obsessed as far as looks go. She was obsessed with the way her body looked. And she knew if she was obsessed with exercise, then that would in turn make her look better. Yeah, I think she made it pretty much number one priority in her life at that time.
She was obsessed with working out down here. Even after high school, we'd see her at Gold's Gym all the time, just all the time.
There was one point when I was in the hospital for a couple days because of dehydration from taking diuretics and, you know, trying to make myself throw up and working out like crazy every day.
She would weigh her food. She would throw up after meals. And I didn't even realize it was going on until actually it got to the point where it was very apparent that she was losing weight.
She would wear lots of sweatshirts and pants, both. Not only probably just to hide it, but because she was cold all the time, just to cover her body because her body was being so depleted.
There were so many low points, actually making myself throw up. It's so disgusting, it's so unattractive and so unhealthy. And I think when you're sitting there with your head in the toilet after eating, you know, a half a piece of cake, you know you're in trouble then. The modeling agency finally told me, "Please don't lose any more weight, you look sick." That's when I started realizing, okay, this isn't the way I want to live the rest of my life. That's when I really started admiring the fitness girls and the fitness magazines and copying their workouts and diet secrets, as in eating every 3 hours and making sure you eat at least 1,500 calories a day.
She really liked the look of those girls, and so she decided that's what she wanted to do. And that way, She could eat, she could look good, and she fit in.
And she realized, oh, you know, the more muscle I build, the faster my metabolism goes and the more she can eat. And we had kind of talked about both of us doing fitness competitions. And then when she won her first big competition, which was the Galaxy in Florida, she called me. I got first place, I can't believe it.
It's somewhat of a miracle, I think, that I went from one extreme to the complete other when trying to pack on muscle and you know, really working out and stuff. That's really when I got out of it, myself. You know, the biggest lesson that I've learned is I struggled so much to be like what I saw in the magazines, and the harder you try, it seems like the harder it is to achieve that. You can't look at airbrushed pictures of girls that are impossible to emulate and, you know, try to be like that. It's just unhealthy.
I'm amazed that she came out of it so good. I think actually it's primarily because she discovered a good balance between exercising and other things in her life. Because I've noticed now, she's still just as fit. She eats like a horse, and if she misses 2 or 3 days of exercise, that's okay.
I wasted so much time and energy trying to eat right and exercising my life away when I feel like I look better now with a little more weight on my body, and I work out, you know, 4 times a week, an hour, you know, max, and I feel better. I'm living a life that I can actually, you know, pay attention to and remember. And I'm still, you know, kicking myself for all those years that I wasted. But, you know, it's a big learning lesson, and hopefully I can help other people.